Earlier today, ASU's W.P. Carey School of Business honored some of Arizona's top companies at the school's annual Spirit of Enterprise Awards. Here to tell us what sets these businesses apart in this tough economic climate is Gary Naumann. He's director of the Spirit of Enterprise Center at ASU's W.P. Carey School of Business. Good to have you here. Thanks for joining
us. Thank you, Ted. Appreciate it.
Spirit of Enterprise Awards, what are we talking about here?
What we're talking about is 10 companies that have made it through a very long process where we start almost a year ago. And we get nominees, take applications, anywhere up to 250 nominees. They have to decide, are they going to go through this process, which is very rigorous, of actually filling out this application while they're trying to run their businesses and answering these essay questions. What are your core strategies? What drives your business? What have you done in terms of customer service? How do you treat your employees? How do you give back to the community? So we put them through the rigors, and at the end of that rigor, we come up with 40, 50 applications, and out of those, we start deciding who's going to make it to the 10 finalists of Spirit of Enterprise finalists.
And some of your finalists, everything from an air ambulance to Ollie the trolley to a fiber optic engineering firm, just that's all sorts of things in there.
And we don't go for specific categories. We don't say, give us one of these and two of these, whatever. We take all comers and we try to decide who of that group represent our 10 best finalists, and out of that we carve it down to 5 winners.
You kind of mentioned what some of the essay questions were, but what is really being recognized here?
Really being recognized here, and it's our one of our taglines, if you will, is celebrating ethics, energy, and excellence in entrepreneurship. So it's not just a series of parameters. How many people do you have, or how fast have you grown, or what's the year-over-year growth and profits? We're really trying to find some great stories. That's what the Spirit of Enterprise is all about. Give us some great stories that we can use to profile ethics, energy, and excellence in entrepreneurship.
Obviously, there are still great stories out there, but I'm guessing some of those stories are harder to find because of the economy. Talk about the challenges right now, especially for small businesses in Arizona, around the country, some of the things, some of the hoops and hurdles that folks are having to go through with this tough economic climate.
Well, it is, because what you find with a lot of small businesses is really time is such a constraint. They don't have the luxury of saying, well, I think I'll go out and think about my business for the next couple of months and then take action on that. Most small businesses are in the position of saying, I need to work in my business every day, so I don't have as much time to work on my business. Obviously, one of the important things for them to do is to step back and say, what do I need to do differently today than I did 6 months or a year or 2 years ago? What's changed? Do I have a heightened awareness of what's going on around me? How do I actually move to the next step? That's hard to do, especially when you're putting in the long hours. That, you know, one of the things I tell my students in my entrepreneurship courses is the beauty of entrepreneurship is you get to decide which 80 hours a week you get to work. And they say, okay, I get it.
Yeah. Is Arizona different? Obviously, we got hit awfully hard.
We got hit very hard.
So small businesses a little
tougher here because we're in the position of we've had some very good years. And now we've had, you know, 4 going on 5 pretty tough years. And not all parts of the country went up as fast as we did. We had a period of great growth, and then all of a sudden, so the faster you go, the harder it is when you slow down.
Yeah.
And so that's what we're looking at here. And yeah, we've got some special challenges, but it'll be back.
Last question. Biggest reason a small business succeeds, biggest reason a small business fails. Got about a minute.
Okay. If I had to say the biggest reason a business is people actually understand and know their business. You can't not pay attention to that detail. That's the biggest reason they succeed is they've chosen something that they're very passionate about, and it's no holds barred. They are just going after it every day. What can I do next to make this thing grow?
And failure is the exact opposite?
It really is. It's people that say, I'm waiting for something to happen for me. You can't wait. Nobody's going to come along and bail you out. You've got to say, what am I going to do tomorrow to fix this? And if you don't, you're going to be gone.
Gary, it's good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much, Ted.